And all present here. I'm Shankari, zoo educator of Arunjana Zoological Park. Happy to welcome you once again for the day two session of Virtual Zoo Ambassador Program. Hope every one of you are staying safe and doing good. Hope you all enjoyed the day one session and have learned more about the Mechanicus tigers. We are glad and overwhelmed with your assignment submitted for the day one session. Good going, kids. Keep doing it. We also thank the parents for your support given to us. We are also very glad to present the Zoo Ambassador Program day two session to our virtual medium for the first time.
Good afternoon, participants.
So before proceeding, I'd just like to give you instructions how the program is going to go. All the participants will be in a default mute option once the session started. Participants can ask the questions about the topic in the question and answer session. During the end of the session, few minutes will be allowed for the participant to interact directly with the presenter to discuss your questions. Participants should click on the raise hand option at the bottom of the screen, and randomly few participants will be picked up for the discussion. In today's session, we are going to learn about the endemic, an animal in endangered conservation status, which is known for the distinct features of a majestic silver mane around the face with a tuft on its tail, which resembled lion, and hence it got the name lion-tailed macaque. And hence it got the name lion-tailed. Welcome the presenter of the day, Dr. A. Manimoli. Dr. A. Manimoli is a senior biologist of Arunjana Zoological Park and has more than 32 years of experience. He has completed a PhD in wildlife biology, and he has authored more than 50 scientific research articles in different national and international journals. He is currently guiding PG and MPhil scholars for undertaking research in the area of wildlife science. He has participated in several national and international workshops and seminars conducted in the field of wildlife. He has organized several educational programs, workshops, seminars for various target groups on conservation breeding of endangered animals. Now, the section is going to begin. I'm going to hand over the session to the presenter, Dr. A. Manimoli.
Good afternoon, participants. It is my pleasure to take classes on endemic lion-tailed macaque. Endemic means a particular organism or animal which lives in a particular area or particular state or particular nation. We can call it as a So now I am before going to the lion-tailed macaque, like to brief about primates of India. There are four groups of primates available in India. One is gibbon, second is langurs, third is macaques, and fourth is lorries. So gibbon is only found in northeastern India, but langurs, macaques, and lorries, which are found throughout India. So the langurs and macaques having some differences. The langurs comparatively larger than the macaques, and the tail also long. The macaques having cheek pouch in its mouth, but the langurs doesn't have. Another one, the lorisidae, that is a loris. There are two species available in India. One is slender and another one is slow loris. Okay, in Tamil Nadu, we are having five species of primates. One is common langur, second is Nilgiri langur, bonnet macaw, lion tail macaw, and slender loris. Unfortunately, all of them in the endangered. In one Indian Wildlife Protection Act, they are under Schedule 1. So now this is a very brief about Indian primates. Now I am switching over to lion tail monkey. The lion tail macaw or the Wanduru is an old-world endemic to the Western Ghats or South India. The hair of the lion tail macaw is black. Its outstanding characteristic is the silver white man, which surrounds the head from the cheeks down its chin, which gives this monkey its a German name, Patrafi or beard ear. The hairless face is black in color. It ranks among the smaller macaws. The tail is medium in length with the black tuft at the end, similar to the lion tails. The male's tail tuft is more developed than that of the female. So the Aringer Anna Zoological Park is a coordinating zoo as far as lion tail macaw is concerned. Apart from that, Nilgiri langur and Nilgiri thar also we are the coordinating zoo. The participating zoos are Thiruvananthapuram and Rajendra Zoological Park, Mysore. They are participating zoo in the lion tailed breeding program. When you look at the behavior of lion tail macaw, the lion tail macaw is a rainforest dweller and it's a diurnal animal, which means they are active during daylight hours. It is a good climber and spends a majority of its life in the upper canopy or tropical moist evergreen forest. When it is in a group, the lion tail macaw is much like other macaws, living in a hierarchical groups of usually 10 to 20 members, which usually consists of few males and many females. It is a territorial animal, defending its area first with a loud cries towards the invading troops. If this proves to be fruitless, it brawls aggressively. This aggressive interaction can range from simple chase or igniting a fight when feeling aggravated. Lion tail macaw behavior is characterized by typical patterns such as arboreal living, selectively feeding on large variety of fruits, trees, large inter-individual spaces while foraging, and time budget with a high proportion of time devoted to exploration and feeding. In the wild, they feed on leaves, flowers, buds, and animal proteins, etc. Now I am talk about the population of lion tail macaw in captivity at Aringer Anna Zoological Park. Aringer Anna Zoological Park, one of the foreigner and keeping lion tail macaw since 1983. The first breeding was noticed in the year 1986 with the founders of one male and three female from Valparai. So far we have produced 63 young ones and 34 deaths we recorded. Currently Aringer Anna Zoological Park housing 22 animals, of which 10 males and 12 females in 3 different enclosures. Right now, 2 males and 5 females are breeding vigorously. A total of 17 animals have been used for animal exchange program. If you look at the population of lion tail macaw in Indian zoos, there are 53 individuals available in 12 different zoos in India. Of it, the Thiruvananthapuram having 11 individuals and Mysore Zoo having 4 animals. So though they are both zoos are participating zoos, the breeding is very less when compared to Aringaranna Zoological Park. Okay, whenever breeding on endangered animals, marking of animals play a major role in the breeding program. So the numbers which is very identical to this one. So every animal is fixed with the transponder. So we are you know, there is ID. The ID was recorded in the animal history sheet. We can record all its features like date of birth, parents, parentage, lineage, when it was sexually matured, everything, you know, we are marking in the one kind of software that is called SIMS. The SIMS, you know, we are incorporating individual animal records and behavior. Okay, right now the Aringaranna Zoological Park having 3 enclosures for lion-tailed macaque. One is for public exhibit and 2 other enclosures which are exclusively for breeding purpose. You are seeing in the picture, it is an animal house where, you know, the animal was fed without any disturbance. The visitor exhibit is surrounded by a water that is called wet moat. And, you know, there are each enclosure having a full of vegetations. The enclosure has natural vegetation like Asadirecta indica, Indica dulci. Indica is dulci is nothing but kodukapuli. That plant is, you know, all parts are edible to lion-tailed macaque and other herbs and shrubs. The enclosure is having predominantly Indica dulci, which provides feed to the animals. Indica dulci is a species serves as a climbing, perching, and natural feeding other than our zoo diet. The seed pods contain a sweet and sour pulp that which an animals eaten raw as an accompaniment to various meat dishes and used as a base for drinks with sugar and water. The seeds are also edible and refined to extract oil, which amounts 10% of their weight. They also contain 28% of the protein. Yeah, this is right now you are seeing the wet moat. I already told you the moat which is surrounded by water. And the other slide you are seeing the social group of animals. Lion-tailed macaque, there is a dominant male in the center and followed by females and the young ones. Then other 2 enclosures are dry moated. There is no water in the moat. So here we have developed a simulated natural environment by planting majority of the feeding plants like Annona squamosa, Bambusa bambus, Ficus religiosa, Asadirecta indica, Indica dulci, Psidium Guajava, Terminalia catapa. Like that, there are so many tree species which are planted and using as, you know, the animal exhibit all natural behaviors like searching, feeding, climbing, and so on. As far as animal health and hygiene concerns, we have a dedicated keepers. Every day they are cleaning the night house, and you know, we are not using any chemical in the rooms for cleaning. We are using turmeric powder, which is a anti-infectant. It will prevent entry of any bacteria or virus. Similarly, the yard is also cleaned daily. As far as deworming concern, our doctors prescribe some deworming tablets for every 6 months, and also health tonic for the improvement of the health. The keepers are also checked for any contagious disease to common health camp once in a year or twice in a year. The moat water is cleaned and the enclosure vegetation are pruned regularly. So as far as a diet chart concern, you know, every animal in the zoo having a diet chart, but I don't know how many humans are having the diet chart in their lifetime. All the zoos, all the zoo individuals, individual species having diet chart. If you look at the diet chart of our lion-tailed macaw, it's ranged, you know, 14 types of food items like rice, groundnut, banana, guava, Bengal gram, cabbage, greens, red slices, soya bean, pex, carrot, grapes, honey, sweet lime, boiled. Other than that, during the seasons, the seasonal fruits also we are giving. Other than that, to frozen fruits during the, as a part of summer management, we are giving a lot of succulent varieties of leaves and fruits. So, as far as animal and the enrichment is the another topic which is very, very important for any animal species in captivity. Enrichment is a dynamic process in which changes to structure and husbandry practices are made with the goal of increasing behavioral choices to animal and drawing out their species appropriate behaviors and abilities that enhancing animal welfares. Keeping above concept in the mind, Aringarana Zoological Park has improved the captive environment of lion-tailed macaw by way of providing swings, ropes, hammocks, perches, loft, platform, basket bee feeding, etc. If anything goes abnormal in the animals, we have a inbuilt squeeze cage. It is serving as a capture mechanism and treatment for our pets. Okay, now I will going to talk about breeding biology and breeding season. Whatever data I am presenting here, it's not copied from any textbook. It is my 38 years experience we recorded in Aringarana Zoological Park. There are more than 63 births have been taken, and the birth minimum of 2 and the maximum of 11 births recorded. The maximum birth of 11 individuals noticed in the month of August, and in the month of January and May, July, followed by 5 births in the month of April and June respectively. In the month of February and March, 4 births were recorded. In the month of October and December, at least 2 and 3 births were noticed in November. So during our study, we also analyzed the birth and the sexual maturity of lion-tailed macaw. The captive born female animal produced their first young one at an average age of 4.63 years. Similarly, captive born male became father at an average age of 6.62 years. So interbirth interval, that means the difference between first birth and second birth of the animal ranged from 1 year 4 months. So this was recorded, this is the average one, this is recorded in 13 liters. The gestation period showed that 6 months and 16 days. No parturition. Parturition is nothing but giving birth, was observed in daytime. All the births were single. Twice twins were born in captivity. Birth occurred all months. Maximum birth noticed in the month of August. Next, I am going to talk about the longevity and the fecundity. Longevity means lifespan, and the fecundity is the breeding period. How long the animal, at what age the animal can breed. Our observation showed that maximum of one male animal lived 30 years, and that's called Mohen, and the female which was lived 25 years, that is called Bama. The female produced maximum of 12 and a minimum of 5 young ones in its lifespan. An average of 7 young ones are produced by females in its lifetime. The females actively breed between from 5 years to 20 years of age. In our Rangaranna Zoological Park, a male sired, that means appava irundirukke, minimum 8 and maximum 14 times with an average of 12 young ones in its lifetime. Okay, the natality is the birth rate, which already I told you there are 63 young ones which born up to 2017, of which 27 are males, 30 are female, and 7 are ancestors. The maximum percentage of females are produced than the males. Okay, the tabular column showing the, you know, I told you there is they breed throughout year. The maximum birth noticed in the month of August, that's 11 birth, followed by May and January. So that in the wild, you know, that is the monsoon season where plenty of food is available. There, you know, most of the LTM breed in the winter season. That is also replicated here. But, you know, in captivity, you know, a very good diet chart, we are giving very good food. So, okay, they are breeding throughout year. Mortality is the death rate. So zoo has recorded 29 deaths, of which, you know, most of the animals died of infighting. Then we can call it as a shock. Then pneumonia. Some are stillborn. Two cases we observed observation. Two cases we observed heart attack. One occasion we observed tuberculosis. Like that, you know, there are so many causes which are contributing the death of 29 LTMs. So I am presenting here now the age distribution of lion-tailed macaque in our current population structure. Right now we are having that blue color represent the male, the red color represent the female, the green color, which are very, very recently born animals. We have 0 to 5 years. That means we are having 8 animals. And 5 to 10 years, we are having 7 animals. So put together, there are 15 animals. That is a very good population. It can sustain the zoo population well. So we are when come back to older animals, we are keeping younger and mid-age groups. That is a very positive trend for our zoo management. Then we are maintaining the pedigree of LTM. What is a pedigree? Pedigree is nothing but it's a family history. We acquired one male, two female from wild, that is Mohan, Rukmani and Bama. From there, whole population was evolved by selecting particular male and female. We can go ahead with the breeding and we are maintaining the genetic variability. The genetic variability is very, very important because the gene flow or alleles of the genes should be different, should not be same. If your population grow continuously in future, we need to maintain the heterozygosity of the lion-tailed macaque. So how to experiment or find out genetic variability? There is a CCMB, Center for Cellular Molecular Biology at Hyderabad. We sent all our fecal samples of all our animals and we tested for genetic variability that showed, the population is still maintaining 85% of the genetic variability. That means I already told it's a good population and it will sustain in future also. This is because of selective breeding. I showed you in the pedigree. We are selecting the male and female or father, mother, sibling to avoid inbreeding. Even two distinct LTM population across Palghat Gap, this will be taken care of breeding program. Very recent finding. Previously, we thought that a lion-tailed macaque is a single species. Very recently, the CCMB came to conclude that there is a subspecies in lion-tailed macaque. So this is very, very important for us because we should not mix them, have a breeding program. We are breeding these animals. Maybe some of the participants are very, very curious about it. Because of various reasons, the LTM population are reducing. A recent assessment for IUCN report, 3,000 to 3,500 animals live and scattered over several areas in Kerala, Karnataka, and Tamil Nadu. The lion-tailed macaque ranks among the rarest and most threatened primates. And also, now the population living in small fragmented habitat of Western Ghats. The fragmentation itself leads to, the endangered situation. Apart from that, spread of agriculture, tea, coffee, teak and cinchona, construction of water reservoirs for irrigation and power generation and human settlements made them endangered. Apart from that, olden days, before 1972, the people used to hunt this animal for flesh and fur. Now totally it is under control. So yesterday Dr. Sridhar explained that a tiger is the apex of the food chain. But here also every organism, every animal species in the planet is doing some role in the ecosystem. So So as far as a lion-tailed macaque is concerned, they are, you know, helping our ecosystem by way of spreading the seeds. Okay, they eat a lot of roots, and that seeds are carried over other areas. You know, it useful for natural germination of forest. So as a students, you all need to conserve this our very charismatic endemic endangered lion-tailed macaque. I hope you will all involve in the conservation breeding program of lion-tailed macaque. Thank you. We are going to I wanted to display some of the films in between my talk, but somewhat it's not possible, but now we are going to play the lion-tailed macaque natural habitat and how it is kept in the zoo. So right now you are seeing the Valparai forest, which is part of Western Ghats. Where the most of the population, there is one area called Pundottam. There is a urbanized forest. Human settlements are very nearby. They adapted human being. Once the population was dwindling, then there was a sudden increase within 3 years. Now that Pundottam area having a very good population there among the tea and coffee plantations. You can see in the picture. The picture itself is a self-explanatory how it is associated with the people there. Thank you. Right now, you are seeing the enclosure of lion-tailed macaw. This is a visitor view area. See the complexity of the enclosure. You know, though we have a very good Inca dulce trees and hammock inside, there is a lot of branches, tree ropes we have provided to them. So for any conservation breeding, you need to have such a simulated natural environment for the breeding. Such a environment only helpful for our future reintroduction program. So this is a social grouping. They are reflecting the natural behavior, how the young ones and the sub-adults are playing each other. See, the mother is in another tree. Right now you are seeing the how we are feeding the animals. So the dominant male, you know, in the hierarchy of lion-tailed macaw, if you put the food in a heap, the dominant male take away all major food items, which is very juicy or tasty. Others will not get it. So our keeper now dispersing all fruits in different areas of the enclosure. So everyone get the opportunity to take all types of food, like groundnut and soaked Bengal gram. They all thrown or spreaded over enclosure. So right now you are seeing this is a interspecies interaction. This is also recorded in the wild, how the Indian giant squirrel and our lion-tailed macaw coexist and, you know, steal the food from Malabar Indian giant squirrel. There is a competition is everywhere for food, for space, for everything. See, it's taken away the jackfruit from the plucked out from the tree and they're throwing out, you know, the macaques can feast the trees. Such a wonderful species. It's a wild feeding behavior. Thank you for your watching and your patience to hear my lecture. Thank you one and all.
Thank you, sir. Now the forum is open for the question and answer session. We have few questions in the chat box. We'll just discuss that first. So the question is, why do we have dry mode and wet mode for animals?
Very good question. So bungalow is a reserve forest where previously, you know, there was a water scarcity, and also the more water having a, you know, we need to change every year or every 6 months. So both of them is very good for lion-tailed macaw. So in order to, you know, avoid over usage of water, we are using dry mode in the breeding area. In the exhibit area, is that's a old enclosure that was planned that time. It's a small enclosure where we are keeping water.
Thank you, sir. And the next question is, how long do they reproduce and how many times?
Yeah, it was actually covered in my lecture. Okay, they you know, the, during its lifetime, minimum 5 and maximum 7 young ones they produce in its lifetime. Average of 7 birds in its lifetime.
And what is the average lifespan of lion-tailed macaque?
Yeah, in the wild, they live 15 to 20 years, but in captivity, they live 25 to 30 years. Because ensured feeding and health care given by Swatha.
Okay. And why are these macaques or endangered species?
Yeah, again, you know, because of human being, you know, we are very, you know, we are utilizing the natural resources in a broad manner, you know, for agriculture purpose, and you know, most of the forestry area become fragmented, so that it was endangered. That is also covered in my lecture, previous lecture.
Yes, sir, thank you. And what is the meaning of unsexed?
Yeah, that's a very good question. Unsexed in the sense, you know, the if you seen my photographs or in the films, the animals, the mother carry the baby young one in its ventro-ventral contact. We will not be able to see the sex organ up to, you know, when it's separated from the mother. So the that things, you know, that we are not sure of such sex. So we will call it as unsexed.
Thank you, sir. And the next question is, do ever animal keeper interact with the lion-tailed macaque?
Yeah, that's a very good question. But yeah, many foreign zoos, they allow interaction with the animals. As far as our zoo is concerned, we are not allowing much interaction with the animals as far as the lion-tailed macaque is concerned, because these are the gene pools we are going to use for future reintroduction programs. If you allow the keeper to socialize with the animal, that specimen will not be used for release back into the wild, because it will not fear or it will not go away from human being. So we will not allowing a keeper to close with animals.
Thank you, sir. The next question is, how do you recognize if it is a male or a female?
Yes. You know, the morphologically, males are bigger than females. Even a common visitor can be easily identify the sex.
Moreover,
it's having scrotum. And I told you, the tail is having a more tuft of hairs in the males. And then visibly there is a scrotum. The mature females, definitely you can see the perianal gland. That is some will show you as a female.
Thank you, sir. And the next question is interesting. What is the difference between loris, macaque, and langur?
Yeah, good. Yeah, I told you in South India, we are having langurs, larger in size. They are black in color or gray in color with long tail. Macaques, you know, they are a little smaller in size. Their tail also very less. Okay, they are the macaques having cheek pouch. That cheek pouch is, you know, they will store the food temporarily for, you know, they will go and collect and eat and will store in the cheek pouch. That facility is not having in langurs. They all diurnal animals, both of them. But loris is a nocturnal. It is a very tiny animal, small animal. That is Tamil la thevaangnu solvaanga. Adukku paathinga tail illaama maari therigum, small tail. Anala easy a neenga idha kandupidikkalam.
Thank you, sir. The next question is, what is the total population of wild LTM in India?
Yes, நீங்க இத லெக்சர் கவனிச்சிருந்தீங்கன்னா அதுலயே தெரிஞ்சிருக்கும். நம்ம 3,500 இருக்கலாம்னு நம்ம சயின்டிஸ்ட் சொல்லிருக்காங்க. அதுவும் வந்து யோர் இன் தி ஃபார்மேட்டட் ஃபாரஸ்ட் ஆஃப் 3 ஸ்டேட்ஸ்.
Okay, so this is the last question. What is the LTM favorite food?
Yeah, in the last video you seen that jackfruit, they are delicious very much. Apart from that, there is a collinium, there is a vedipala அப்படின ஒரு plant இருக்கு, அதையும் ரொம்ப நல்ல விரும்பி சாப்பிடுவாங்க. அதான் தட் யூ நோ மோர் தென் 56 பிளான்ட்ஸ் சயின்டிஸ்ட் ஐடென்டிஃபைட் அஸ் தேர் ஃபீடு. அப்பார்ட் ஃப்ரம் தட் யூ நோ தே ஆல்சோ லவ் மீட் ஆஃப் கலோட்டஸ் சம் பேர்ட்ஸ் எக்ஸ் அண்ட் இன்ஃபன்ட்ஸ் ஆஃப் ஸ்குரல் எக்ஸெட்ரா.
Thank you, sir. And now we can go for interactive session. Participants can interact with the presenter. Participant can click the raise hand option below the screen. So randomly few members will be selected for the day.
Sir, there is another question. We will discuss that. In the meantime, what is the difference between endangered and extinct?
Yeah, very good question. Extinct is a term, you know, it no more. So it is already gone from earth. Endangered means they are in the ICU or, you know, they are in a very critical situation. We need to take conservation measures for them.
Thank you, sir. Do the monkeys swim in water?
Yeah, very good question. Yeah, certain monkeys, you know, bonnet macaque, they like swimming. But as far as lion-tailed macaque is a water phobic animal, that's why, you know, we have provided water in the moat. Okay, when we force them, they can swim, but you know, naturally they will not swim, they will not like water for swimming.
Thank you, sir. And one more question, how many monkeys are there in AZP?
Yeah, right now we are having a 22 lion-tailed macaque, of which 10 and 12 females.
And how much does LTM eat a day?
Sorry?
How much do a monkey eat a day?
20. Yeah. You mean how much they require per day?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, they are all very small animal. They usually, you know, if we are giving, you know, nearly 500 to 600 grams. That is shared in morning and evening. All food together.
Thank you, sir. We have one participant.
Biswada.
Hello, sir.
Good afternoon.
This is Naishika, and I'm asking a question. So, do you leave the animal after a certain period of time? After a certain period of time, you raise it?
Not now. You mean releasing into the wild?
Yeah.
Yeah, now we are building up a population. Once we have a very good group, then we may think of releasing back into the wild.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you. John, Michael. John, Michael, Sebastian, no, okay.
Yes, sir.
Satya, see that? John, Michael?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, please ask your question.
Sir, actually, I didn't understand some things like you said in Tamil.
Okay, I spoke only a little bit in the last.
Yeah, I didn't understand that.
Which portion?
Okay.
Right. There is a jackfruit the animal was eating. You know, there is a competition between lion tail macaque and the Indian giant squirrel.
Okay. Okay. So
the jackfruit they are eating.
Okay.
I used some Tamil word. You ignore it.
Okay.
Muhammad Asharaf Ali. Muhammad, are you on the line? Satya Sridhar.
Hello?
Yes.
Sir, how many hours do the lion tail macaw sleep?
Yeah, very good, Ma. It's like our, you know, human being. During 8 hours, okay, they are from 8 to 10 hours, they will sleep during the night hours, as like human.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Welcome. Next call, Shalini. Balamurugan.
Hello, sir.
Tell me.
You told that macaws can eat meat.
Yeah, of course. This lion tail macaw.
So are they omnivores?
Yes.
Many of the monkeys are don't like eggs. But you told that they eat eggs.
Yeah.
So are they omnivores?
Yeah, lion tail macaque is an omnivore. So here we are not giving any meat. Instead of that, we are giving egg. Okay. We are also giving some insects.
Oh, thanks, sir.
Okay. Srinath Venkatraman, are you in the line? Ramana Kailash?
Sir. Hello, sir.
Yeah, please.
Sir, I have two doubts, sir.
Sorry?
I have two doubts, sir.
Yeah, please. Go ahead.
What is the scientific name of Vedipala?
That is a Collinia. Yes, I know the general name, Collinia, then maybe I will let you know the letter. You can ask another question.
Okay, sir. Which animal is the closest relative to LTM?
Our bonnet macaque, rhesus macaque, all macaques. Okay, pigtail macaque.
Okay, sir.
Okay, I told you that all macaques having cheek pouch. Okay.
You understand? Yes,
yeah.
Hello, sir. Can you hear me?
Yeah, please go ahead.
Sir, what kind of predators do they have in the wild?
Yeah, very good question, ma.
Hello.
Yeah, I will tell you. You know, as a young one, there are some eagles, vultures, then a leopard, tiger.
Hello.
Hello. Who is on the line? Okay, the leopard and tiger also hunt the LTM.
So there are leopards.
Yeah.
There are leopards and tigers in the Western Ghats too.
Yeah, of course.
Oh, okay, sir.
Next, Abhirami. Siddharth, Sukumar, line la irkingla?
Yes, I'm there, sir.
Yeah, shoot your question.
Do the young ones of the lion-tailed macaque look similar to monkeys?
Your voice is not audible.
Is it audible now, sir?
Yeah, please go ahead.
Yeah, sir, I have two questions, sir.
Yeah, please shoot one by one.
Do the young ones of the lion-tailed macaque look similar to monkeys?
Yeah, of course. It's like your father, mother. It's having all, you know, hairs. Everything look like adult, but the size is very small.
Okay. And the next question is, do female macaques have the mane-like structure?
Yeah, of course. But you know that when compared to males, it is a lesser manes, but it's having mane. Female also having manes.
Thank you, sir.
You're welcome.
Sir, I have a doubt.
Yeah, please go ahead.
Do zoos adopt any measures during disaster times?
Yeah, very good question, ma. Yeah, we keep on watching on that, you know, level of moat water, and also, you know, no trees fell from the moat there from the animal escapes. So we have a CCTV camera in all enclosures. We are monitoring it.
Okay, sir.
Kanakavalli. Kanakavalli, are you in the line? Deepika Prasanna.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, how do the lion tail macaque communicate?
Yeah, very good question. You know, they are having several languages. They can communicate with each other. Okay. Hooting is one kind of communication technique they are following. You know, they will express their anguish. They can express their happiness. They can exhibit their feelings.
Sir,
we have room to one more question.
Yeah. The last participant, you can shoot your question.
Hello.
Yes.
Am I audible? Did the LTMs become endangered because of lab testings? Like, are they used for lab testings?
Your voice vittu varuduma. Your voice is breaking. I could not catch your question.
Okay, are LTMs used for lab testing?
What? You repeat again.
Are LTMs used for lab testings?
No, no, no. It's an endangered species, no?
So
it, lab testing...
Did it become endangered because of that?
No, no, no. Absolutely no.
Thank you, sir, for the informative session. I'm sure through this session, our young minds have known about the distant futures of LTM, and also you have navigated them to the care and protection that we give in our zoo. If any of you are interested to adopt an animal and willing to contribute a minimum amount for the care and feed, you can visit our zoo website, www.aazp.in/animal-adoption. You are open to adopt any animal that you like. So before ending the session, I would like to tell about today's assignment. The topic of today is the way to conserve LTM. So the young minds are open to share their views, their thoughts for the conservation of LTM and how to conserve the LTM in wild. Assignment in any form is welcome. Please keep doing it and don't forget to send us. And we are going to end this today's session. Thank you, sir. Thanks to all the participants who are eagerly participated for the today's show. See you all tomorrow, same time, in the day 3 session on living in harmony with elephants with our Dr. Park Alenjin. Participants will be getting a link to the of the session 30 minutes before the program to the register email ID. So please also send us the feedback about this program in our zoo social media pages, as well as you can write to us to aazpzooschool@gmail.com. Thank you so much. See you all tomorrow at 4 o'clock. Thank you.